This is going to be the second video about evaluating functions. And what I want to do in this video is talk about evaluating functions when you're given a function as a table of values or when you're given it as a graph. So let's start with a table. Here I've got a table of values. I've got two columns. The first column on the left, which would be the input column or the independent variable column, has a 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. And the column on the right, the output column, or the dependent variable column, which is labeled G, has 72, 90, 81, 73, and 95. Well, since I've got an input and an output, and I've got only one output for each input, this would be a function. And I could call this function, function G, since that's what the output is. The input is t, so I'm going to call it g of t. And now if I'm told to evaluate, let's say, g of 2, all I have to do is find out when the input column has a 2 in it. In other words, when t equals 2, and find out what the output is there. Well, the output when t is 2 is 90, so g of 2 equals 90. If I want g of 4, I look down my input column until I get to the 4, and I find out that the corresponding output is 73. So g of 4 equals 73. If you're given an input which isn't in your table, let's say I was told to find g of 3.7, since 3.7 is not one of my inputs, I can't do this. As far as I know, 3.7 is not within the domain of the function. It's not one of the valid inputs for the function. So I cannot do that. But as long as I'm given an input which is in my input column, my independent variable column, I can evaluate the function. Okay, and that's really all there is to that. Let's look at graphs. Here I've got a graph, and instead of an x and y axis, I've got an a axis as my horizontal axis, that would be where the input goes, and I've got a d axis as my vertical axis where the output goes. And since this graph would pass the vertical line test, I know it's the graph of a function, so I could say that this is a graph of the function d, that's my output, of a, which is my input. And then if I'm told to use the graph to evaluate, let's say, d of negative 1, well, all I'm going to do is say, what's the output when the input is negative 1? Well, when the input is negative 1, that's negative 1 on the horizontal axis, I'll go up until I get to the graph, and it looks like that's at the point where d, or the vertical value, equals 2. I could label this point negative 1, comma 2. So d of negative 1 is going to be 2. Let's say I'm told to evaluate d of, 3. Okay, so I'll go to the 3 on the horizontal axis, on the a-axis, and I find out that when a equals 3, the d value is just 0. I could write this as an ordered pair, 3 comma 0 with my input and my output. So d of 3 is going to equal 0. I guess let's do one more just to make sure you've got it, but I think they're pretty easy. So let's do d of 2. Okay, so when my input is 2, I'm looking along the horizontal or a-axis for the 2, and then I want to find out what the output value is. That would be the value that I get on the d-axis, and it looks like I'm going to call that negative 1. So that's going to be the ordered pair, 2 comma negative 1. My input is 2, and my output is negative 1, So d of 2 equals negative 1. Okay? That's all there is to say about it. Take care. I'll see you next time.